everyone, I hope you're all doing very well. Today we're looking at air-to-ground strike with rockets. So if we go to armament screen, we can have rockets on pylons 3, 4, 6 and 7. And we can have all from the Lao 3 launcher with 19 2.75 inch rockets, the Mark 151 high explosive, the Mark 156 white phosphorus Willy Pete, the Mark 5 high explosive anti-tank, Mark 61 Willy Pete with white phosphorus, and the WTU-1B UWP. So hey Chief, taking out light, armor and infantry, high explosive anti-tank for obviously for anti-armor. Willy Pete can be used as incendiary, or actually it's most useful as smoking. In fact, generally the most useful thing about these rockets we find is their ability to find targets, use Willy Pete to smoke the target, and then calling the tank buster with the heavy ordnance. Today we'll go for high explosive on the inner pylons and white phosphorus on the outer pylons. And note that we're also going to take the targeting pod. You can use the targeting pod for laser range finding to increase our accuracy with rockets. It's something we can do. So we're going to take a lightning pod and we'll use that as we go. Request rearming. Okay, both loaded. We'll go and find some targets now. And regards the targeted pod, we'll just start it up in the standing way, but that's going to be covered in a different video. We're in the cockpit now. Before we find our targets, we're going to ensure our master arm is on and our laser arm for our targeted pod is on. Next, we're going to select air to ground. Next, we're going to check our right MFD, which if not on SMS, should be on SMS. It shows you that we're in air to ground. We've currently got CCIP, constantly computed impact point, selected as our method as aim, which is correct. Our rockets, currently selected rockets, are ready, and our currently selected rockets are 38 times Mike 156s. I think that was the Willy Pete. If we want to change that, click that OSB there. Now we've got the Mark 151s. We can fire them in singles from just one rocket pod, or pairs. So if we've got matching rocket pods like we have, then it will fire on a click of a button a pair of rockets, and that button is going to be weapon release there. And this also says that our system is ready. Now, out of interest, we can put these in CCRP mode, constantly calculated release points, a completely different method of firing, by pressing the nozzle steering button once and twice. We've now got the weapon, the rockets in CCRP mode. This does not appear to be implemented yet in the Viper, so it's probably something for the future. I'm going to press nozzle steering again, and we're back to CCIP. We're ready to rock and roll. Now let's just get this into position where we can talk about the Symbology standby. So we can tell here that our master arm is turned on, so we're good to go with arm. We can tell that our master laser arm is there. Now it's not actually firing the laser. If it were firing, it would be flashing, and to get the laser to fire, we'll be pressing the first detent of the trigger, which is that guy there, trigger first detent. So we would hold that down to fire the laser, and then weapon release to actually fire the rockets. The reason for firing the laser is we can get an increase in ranging, therefore our CCIP pipa, our rocket pipa here, will be more accurate. Next, we'll check that we've got CCIP, as we explained earlier, selected, and we have. Next is our slant range. That is the range from us through this rocket reticle here to the intersection point on the ground. That range is currently calculated by the fire control radar. We know because it says Foxtrot there, which is standard practice, and it's currently 3.5 miles. Next is our usual path marker here. This shows where our aircraft is flying. Here is our rocket reticle. That dot there, that pipa there, if we fired the rockets in this current position, would impact where that dot is intersecting the ground, so it accounts for any dip in the rockets. That said, we have a maximum range. That maximum range is 8,000 feet on the slant range. When we are within 8,000 feet, we'll get a little horizontal line across here. That will show that we are within 8,000 and we are in range to fire. Like most weapons, the closer we are to the target when firing, the more accurate we will be, but we suggest not closer than 2,000 feet. Now we need to talk about the dive profile. The optimum dive profile is going to be at 450 knots. The closer we can get to that, the better. It's just optimal for rockets, whatever reason. We're going to dive from at a minimum of 6,000 feet AGL. There's no real limit to how high we can go. The higher we go, generally, the more time we'll get towards targets arranging our run. And the dive angle wants to be as close as we can get it to about 20 degrees. So a mixture of our path marker here and our gun or ball sight cross here, as close to the 20 degrees as possible. And we can have a little closer look at that when we're on our dive. So we're going to find some targets, and we're going to attack them with our high explosive rockets first. So let's get that set up. So 151 is 38 times our explosive rockets. We're going to fire with pairs. Just got to find our targets now. Stand by. In the meantime, let's get some altitude. I should report quickly, at the moment, October 2019, laser ranging does not appear to be working properly. At least we can't get the L to flash with rockets. So it's just something to bear in mind. But I am going to go through the process and press and hold the laser ranging button anyway. Okay, I kind of see some targets out there. I'm going to go to run down the length of them. Now I want to arrange myself so that I'm going to be going about 20 degrees dive. And that's going to be pretty much perfect there. See my path marker coming down to 20 degrees dive. I'm just going to come to the right now. We've got our slant range is 3 miles, so we've got a while to go, yep. Okay, I'm now on target. I'm too fast, so I'm going to come off the gas. It is typical to get a little excited and too fast. It's not the end of the world. Pull up cue down the bottom there. May come into play, we'll see. In range. Okay, done my strafe.
Oh, that looked good.
Did it look good? They're good rockets. That's that's literally the first time I fired these because we're in such a hurry. And wow,
wait,
really
those
cool.
Those were Willy Pete's.
Those Willy Pete's. Oh, I think I ran out of. I think I must have run out of high explosive. Look, and it's automatically switched to Willy Pete's. So I didn't know it did that. Right, awesome. So we've accidentally sent out a load of Willy Pete's there for the tank busters to come in. You come in as a tank buster now, and you do your run, RC. So one thing to note, when you run out of your primary type of rocket, it will automatically go onto the secondary without asking you. Just something to bear in mind. We're going to go into a cruise now. Boom, 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 boom. Beautiful. Very good. Yeah, you went onto your Willy Pete's as well, look.
Yeah.
That's hilarious. Right, so that's pretty much it. It's very simple, very easy to use. If I wanted to just put a single Willy Pete out, I'll put single there. I'll just dab it down there. And that's how I could... put that out. Hope that's useful. See you later.